All right, back for game two. Once again, we have a keepable hand here. Gonna want to draw an island, but we have a two drop. We're on the draw. We're on the draw. And we have think twice, so as soon as we do hit an island, we have a good chance of hitting another. Ooh, and we have a one drop. Go, one drop. Okay, I kind of... No, I'm just going to play the Walking Corpse. I kind of wanted to save Walking Corpse in case he plays Mayor, because I currently lose to it. But if I draw an island, that doesn't actually happen, and if he doesn't play Mayor, it's just way better to have this out there. He would also probably play it on turn two, to be fair. The white doesn't make a ton of sense in this deck. He plays Silver Chase Fox, and he played two planes. He's probably just splashing the... No, because he played a Hinterland Hermit, too. I don't know what he's got, to be honest. Let's kill that thing. Move in. He mulled a 5, so there's a good chance he needs that mana. And if that's the best thing he could do on turn 3, it's, like, pretty good if I kill it there and he misses playing something. Emberwolf is not missing playing something. I'll just keep the pressure up. Pretty happy if he blocks the Walking Corpse here. Alright, so he's down to 13. I mean, our hand's still very good. If we draw an island, we should easily win this game. If we draw a swamp, we're actually not bad either. Gets us one step closer to Sever, and we get a Highland Ghoul in play. Highborn Ghoul, excuse me. Alright, that one's going to be annoying. Okay. Fair enough. So, really just need to draw any amount of lands. We also went up to 18 lands. I mean, 41 cards, but it's still... adding density to your total land count. Snap trade. Can't. I tried. Magic Online would not let me cheat. Land. Alright, that's actually not a bad land. So I can either Highland Ghoul here or Think Twice. I think given my hand, I'm probably just going to think twice. Let's attack with Walking Corpse here. If he blocks, it's fine. If he doesn't, I'll block with Typhoid Rats on the way back. Alright, deal. So now... Yeah, I still think it's correct just to think twice. Going to 10 here, but I can't feel that bad. I mean, all I need is a land to play Bloodline Keeper or a land to play Sever. He's leaving his Immerwolf back. Why? Because of Rebuke? Okay. Highland Ghoul the second. That is that. Alright, let's attack with this Typhoid Rats. He's got three cards in, he's not playing anything, so it kind of scares me to just play this Bloodline Keeper, but if he doesn't have an answer, it's just going to win the game. And if he does have an answer, I don't lose instantly, so. Go to 8. Alright, let's go ahead and kill this Immerwolf. Pass the turn. So we're at 8. We do have to kind of deal with this Voiceless Spirit, but I can just make 2/2s and eventually get out of that mess. Also, I could play any of these things. Alright, well, let's make a 2/2 and block this. He's going to Spider Grasp, but that's fine. And if he doesn't, then that's also fine. The only thing I don't want to hear is Wild Hunger. Oh, sure. I don't get that, but... You'd rather your guy die? Okay. Ooh. That doesn't do much, unfortunately. So, yeah, let's just play. What is the play? I think it's just Highborn Ghoul. Double block this Voice of Spirit with two vampires, so even if he has Wild Hunger, I only take one. Uh-oh. Sure. That is acceptable. Occultist. Is that better than Highborn Ghoul? Probably. I kind of want to attack here. I'll have. No, really don't know. If I draw, I guess if I draw, yeah, I'm gonna play this because if I draw an island, I can go Armored Scab plus this, which is probably pretty good. I am gonna attack this Highborn Ghoul though. Right, pass. So now, if he attacks with the Voice of Spirit, it's kind of interesting because I almost want to triple block it. Wow. All right, so we're just coming in, are we? So if he has Wild Hunger, I am dead. Unless I block here with a Bloodline Keeper here, here. I think that's what I have to do. Otherwise, if he has Wild Hunger, I am actually dead, and I don't want to be dead. So, this is actually pretty good for me if he does have Wild Hunger and wants to kill my Bloodline Keeper, because I still everything else survives except for the Typhoid Rats. I guess Wild Hunger is going to kill me if he has it. Okay. Yeah, I guess I shouldn't have. That was bad. I should have just made a guy and blocked there, but it's fine. He's still losing a lot of stuff here. I did lose Bloodline Keeper, which sucks, but. I think all that at him is correct. Milling myself is not very good. Ooh, got some good ones. All right, Tennis Swamp doesn't do much. It does let me play a Highborn Ghoul. So I guess we just battle here. Play another one. All right, and we just keep passing. A lot of vampires at least. Like, the one thing good about that block was that even if he does, I mean, I guess if he had the trample card, we would have lost. But so that was a mistake on my part. But even if I do make that mistake, because of how far we had are on the board with that particular attack of his, we ended up, you know, being okay no matter what. But yeah, that was just I don't know why I didn't think about his 5/5 getting trampled, but whatever. Anyway, we'll be back for round two, and I will do my best to play slightly better. But luckily, my cards are powerful, and they won me the game.